Route templates are the first step to standardizing approval processes in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. They allow us to call upon them whenever we need to release files, rather than creating individual routes for every change or approval. Route templates will also be used as the basis for change actions, which we'll look at in the final video in this series. For now, let's look at how to set up and use route templates. Let's head to the Route Management app via the Approval Routes tab we set up in previous videos, and click the option to add a new template. We'll name it SOLIDWORKS Approval, and we can also give it a description. Like last time, the purpose of the route is for approvals. The second drop-down controls permissions on the tasks in this template. So we could allow people to modify and extend tasks if need be, but in most cases, we don't want anyone to be able to modify them. So we'll choose Maintain Exact Task List. We'll allow user groups to be selected, and we could also specify that approvers have to include digital signatures when approving. But then we can start adding our tasks on the Tasks tab. This will be a design check. So we'll ask the approver to review the attached contents and approve or reject as appropriate. We have two options to choose who the approver is. We could assign individual users or user groups to be chosen every time the template runs. Or ask whoever initiates the route template, the route owner, each time who the approver should be. For now, we'll choose ourselves as an assigned user so that we can see the notifications as they come in. We'll leave the due date blank, but you can add one if you wish, and then click Apply. You can see that this task workflow looks exactly like the usual route tasks. It will just be baked into a template this time. We could add parallel tasks that require either or both tasks to be completed before progressing to the next stage, but we'll stick with sequential approvals at this point and keep things simple and add a second task. Our second task will be to approve the design. You can add as many stages as you want in a route, and you can involve different departments like manufacturing, sales, or procurement, whoever you want, to be involved with reviewing and approvals. If you do want to create more complex routes, then be sure to look into our 3DEXPERIENCE launch service, where our expert consultants will assist you in the implementation of your 3DEXPERIENCE platform and help you to get the best out of it. At this point, we'll click Apply and set the route template to released. Releasing the template allows other users within your platform to view and use the template. If we were to save it as a draft, then we'd be the only persons with visibility on the template. We'll click on the home icon and look at our templates. We can see that the newly created SOLIDWORKS approvals is ready to use to create a new route. So let's head back to the My Data tab, where the designer within us has modified the cylinder guard part and updated the drawing. We'll need to review and approve the changes before it can be released. When our designer has finished their modifications, they'll head to the Approval Routes tab and create a new route, referencing the parts in the title. Now, instead of defining tasks manually, we can click on the Search Templates button and select the SOLIDWORKS approval template we just created with all the preset tasks ready to go. We want to ensure that the advanced options are set to promote the connected object to the next maturity state, rather than just simply notifying the owner. So please do make sure that you review these settings even when using a route template. Click on the Content tab. And while that's open, we can head back to the My Data tab and control select both of the files before dragging them to the Approval Routes tab and dropping them into our new route window. As in our previous video, we'll set our target maturity to be released. And the task will already be defined by the template. So we don't actually need to do anything there and simply start this route. We'll see notifications that the route's been started. And when we view the My Tasks tab, a quick refresh will show us that there are some tasks assigned to us that we can be getting on with. There's our check design task sitting in to do. and after reviewing the documents attached to the task in 3D Play, we can approve it via the drop-down in the top right corner of the task. Notice this time that the route is not marked as complete yet. Only the first stage has been completed, and the next task in the route is automatically assigned. Task and route management is simple to do in any browser and can even be done on your phone or tablet. So you can be managing your data from the back of the taxi if needed. But when the data is marked as completed, the route is too, and the drawing and the part are marked as released, as shown in the content tab of the route. We'll click on the information icon for the route, and the history tab introduces us to the first bit of traceability. We can see when the route was created and started, who each task was performed by, and any comments along with a completion date. If you click on the Relations tab, it will also show what content was attached to it and when. So, that's how you can create approval route templates to standardize the process of releasing your design data. But this is just the first step to full traceability. The final tutorial in this series will take a look at taking this a step further and show you how to use change actions in conjunction with route templates for an even more comprehensive level of traceability.